There was a 7.6 magnitude earthquake off the coast of the Solomon Islands in the South Pacific this morning. Turns out it did not create a tsunami. And the Pacific Tsunami Warning Center made that call fairly quickly. Kirk Matthews went to find out how they were able to do that. Kirk.
Marissa, those in the know say it has to do with additional resources at their disposal and a change in technology over the years that now gives them a head start. It took just minutes for the scientists at the Pacific Tsunami Warning Center to determine that the Solomon Islands quake posed no tsunami threat for Hawaii. How is that possible?
For starters, there's a lot more instrumentation at our disposal, so we get more data more quickly. Then, for example, today we're pulling in seismic data from 450 instruments distributed around the world, maintained by various network operators.
It was only a few years ago, Weinstein says, the Pacific Tsunami Warning Center was lucky to have just 24 reporting stations around the world, let alone along what's called the Pacific Ring of Fire. Hawaii is isolated in the middle of the Pacific, so earthquakes along that ring of fire obviously get our attention. And it comes to our attention, there have been more quakes in recent days.
Are there more earthquakes happening in the Pacific on the rim of fire right now?
Well, it seems to be a fair bit of activity in the past couple of weeks with what's been happening in Chile. And the other day we had some earthquakes off the coast of Nicaragua that were in the sixes. And today in the Solomon Santa Cruz Islands area.
Just across the street from the warning center, families were enjoying a day at the beach. We wondered if there was concern about a potential tsunami.
You know, with all the technology we have today, all the tsunamis and all the alerts, you know, we're very informed. So with us being here, we want to make sure that everyone's safe.
Weinstein says the recent rash of earthquakes, not necessarily related. The Pacific is the largest ocean on the planet, and the land masses surrounding the ocean are always subject to movement.
And so it's not terribly surprising that we may have great earthquakes in different regions of the ring of fire, so to speak, that occur in relative close proximity with respect to time.
We should point out that April is Tsunami Awareness Month. Always good to have that preparedness kit close at hand and plan an evacuation route in the event of a tsunami. Kirk Matthews, KHON2 News.